Hello, this is the first section of the medium level of our exam formulas training series, and in this video we are going to learn how to use the famous VLOOKUP function. In this section we are going to have three examples for VLOOKUP. So let's start with the first one. In the first example we have two separate tables, and in this question it wants us to bring the unit price for each fruit here, written here. So we are going to use this table to bring the prices. You may have similar cases in your spreadsheets. And in this case, we use VLOOKUP function. So let's start writing our VLOOKUP function. VLOOKUP function has four different parameters. The first parameter is the lookup value, which asks us which value you are going to search for. So we select our value here. The second parameter asks us, okay, you are going to search for this one, but where are you going to look it for? This is our table where we are going to retrieve our values. This will give a small error, but I'm going to explain it in a minute. So, third parameter is, okay, this is our table, but what is the number of column you want to bring? You want to bring the quantity or you want to bring the unit price? So, 1, 2, 3, we want to bring the unit price, so we write 3 here. The last parameter is optional, but we leave it as false because we want to get the exact match. We are going to discuss the approximate match in the later videos. So I write false or I write 0. The same thing for now. And it gives us the 4.8. Let's see. And yes, it is correct. But if I copy and paste my formulas, you see we get an error here for Apple. Why is that? I go inside the formula and see my area, my table area has changed. In order to prevent this, you should get benefit from relative and absolute references in Excel. For this relative and absolute references, check our other video how to use it. For now, I'm going to just use it directly. I'm going to fix my table by using dollar signs. So I copy and paste my formula again. And now you see the table is fixed. It doesn't move. Okay, this worked. The second example is somewhat similar, but it asks us to find the brand name of a stock number. So it asks us to write 886 for the table stock number. Let's write it and let's find the brand of this stock. I'm writing the lookup again, choosing my lookup value, choosing my area by clicking on F4. I'm fixing it and I'm writing 1, 2, 3 for the brand and 0 for the last parameters, and it gives Apple 886. If I change it, for example, 160, it should give me Samsung. Yes, it does. Okay. In the last section, in the last example, we are going to use two-step VLOOKUP. So, in the first step, we are going to find the product of this stock number. But here we have two tables, so in the stock number does not exist in the second table, so we are going to use the first table to find our product. Then we are going to use the found product to find its price. You may have this kind of case in your spreadsheet, so let's work it out. I write my VLOOKUP again, choose my table. I don't need to fix it because I'm not going to copy and paste my formula. Let's leave it like this. I just write 2 this time because this is the first and this is the second column. I want to find the product and this is the last parameter. Okay, 620 is the month. And lastly, the price will have the same logic, but this time we are going to use mouse as a lookup parameter We are going to use this table and second column and exact match. Okay, and let's check our results by submitting our answer, and it seems good. Okay, thanks for watching, and in the next video we are going to learn how to use the if function in Excel.